have one of the two only undefeated teams in the nation. South Carolina back at home here in Columbia, and they're hosting the last team to have beaten them. That would be the Kentucky Wildcats, who took them down in the SEC Tournament Championship game last season. Let's go! Time for hoops. Courtney Lyle alongside National Championship winning head coach Carolyn Peck. And when you talk about South Carolina, you usually talk Aaliyah Boston first, rightfully so. She's the reigning National Player of the Year. But guess what? Zaya Cook is really helping out Aaliyah and the rest of this team right now.
Well, Zaya Cook is leading this South Carolina team in scoring. Finally, in her senior season, the mental has caught up with the physical. And Zaya Cook is having a fantastic senior season. This is the most efficient season of her college career. She is confident on the offensive side. She is locked in defensively. She has brought the sass, the swag to the Gamecocks to finish up in her senior year.
Now look at her numbers from last season to this season, and you mentioned it, that field goal percentage of 43%, that's a career high for Zaya, and that's a reason too that her and Aaliyah Boston are the Wooden late season top 20 watch list. Now the first time they faced Kentucky this season, it was close for three quarters, and Maddie Shear for Kentucky had a lot to do with that.
Maddie Shear came to Kentucky as a facilitator, but she has settled in the role of scorer. The first time these two teams met, Maddie Shear had 25 points. So now you add the scoring of Maddie Shear to go along with Jada Walker at that point guard spot, that really makes this Kentucky offense go, especially when it starts at the top with your point guard.
Yeah, that career high for Maddie Shear last time out. You saw her numbers too different from the non-conference to the conference. She's taken some pressure off of herself scoring, so it's coming more naturally. And South Carolina will control it first.
Kentucky starting out in a 2-3 zone. The key in defending South Carolina is you've got to try to limit points in the paint.
Yeah, Kentucky did not do a good job of that the first time around. South Carolina had 62 paint points. That's their bread and butter. 10 seconds now. Kiera Fletcher will cook, send it out to Zaya Cook. And the offensive rebound by Victoria Saxton. That's a normal thing for the Gamecocks.
I was going to say, you're going to say that a lot tonight. Those second chance opportunities that South Carolina really creates for themselves.
Kentucky's starting lineup, we told you about Maddie Shear. Robin Benton has become a really big scorer for them, too. She's their leading scorer, averaging 17 points a game.
And she is the player that really needs to get going for Kentucky, Robin Benton. She's a three-point shooter, but she's also upped her game on the defensive end. Remember, she transferred in from Auburn, where defense was that was what their calling card was. So she brings that because that's how Kyra Elzey has built this team, built on defense and then scoring points.
Naya Leverretter at the free throw line. She was fouled by Zaya Cook. And the South Carolina starting lineup, we've gotten to know a lot of these starters over the years. Three of them part of that number one recruiting class, now seniors. Victoria Saxton coming back for her fifth year.
Those blue jerseys are not leaving the paint. You see any look to Aaliyah Boston, there are going to be three players around her.
Yeah, Naya Leverretter guarding her. She kicks back out to Cook. They swing it over to Bree Beal for three. That shot's going this year.
A lot of confidence. Bree Beal coming out of high school was a scorer. She just accepted the role of being a defender. That's what South Carolina needs her to do. But now she has expanded that role to put points on the board.
And she's shooting 40% from three.
Say it again for the people in the back.
40% from three. Jada Walker, 5 seconds. Maddie Shear from range, right at the buzzer.
And that's the difference I see from Maddie Shear from the non-conference to the conference. It's catching automatically. Her eyes go to the rim, and she's looking for a shot instead of pass.
Kyrie Elzey told us, she came in, we told her, we need you to score the basketball. And there's some pain points for South Carolina and Aaliyah Boston.
It's going to be tough. When you allow Aaliyah Boston to use her feet and get her position before she gets the ball, it's over.
Again, the National Player of the Year, the National Defensive Player of the Year, and that's a travel on Robin Benton.
Talked about Bree Beal. having to knock down shots from the perimeter. Everybody was collapsed on Aaliyah Boston, and Beal made them pay.
Her 21st three-pointer of the season. She's in the corner now. Boston coming across on the baseline. Oh, went in and out. Victoria Saxton, just a monster on the O-boards.
Are they going to count that one?
Let's see. Yes, they do.
The confidence Bree Beal has gained really over the last couple of years, because she realized defenses against South Carolina, everybody's going to collapse in the paint. When the kick out comes to you on the perimeter, you got to knock it down.
So the foul was on Nia Leverrutter. That's her first. Three ball good by Beal, her second of the night. And Michael McConnell talking to Kyra Elzey and explaining what's happening.
Kyra's like, I got it. I don't need to relive it any more than has already happened.
Cook almost lost it, but regrouped off the screen from Boston. Right at the elbow, and she's fouled. And that's two on Leverrutter. Look, that's an important piece to the Kentucky puzzle, especially when you're battling the bigs inside like South Carolina has.
Yeah, Leverrutter is a huge rebounder for Kentucky and also a terrific defender with length for Aaliyah Boston to have to score over.
So she takes a seat with two fouls. And Zaya Cook gets both. It was a five-point possession for South Carolina.
Bree Beal cashing it in, knocking down three to start it off.
Brought her shot, put it right in her pocket.
She did.
Backed it for the game. Robin Benton can do it too. Bounces around and in. Again, 17 points a game for Robin Benton. Uh-oh. That's going to stay with South Carolina. Dawn Staley, I mean, talking to her at the beginning of the season, she was really excited about the potential of this team. And you asked her today at shoot-around, can you repeat?
And then I said, yeah, can you repeat? And she sat there and then made me say it again. And she said, well, what'd you do? And I was like, repeat.
Yep.
And she said, exactly. I didn't think she heard me.
Yeah. She knew.
She did know.
Where have you seen the biggest growth? Because, I mean, last year's team was obviously really good, the best in the nation, national champions. So what do you think of this year's team?
I think that last year's team, they really felt like there was only one way that they could score, and that was to get the ball inside in the paint. They have diversified their offense. We saw the shooting from Bree Beal. We talked about the evolution and the efficiency of Zaya Cook. So when teams take away the paint, now I think South Carolina is more comfortable scoring from the perimeter.
Jada Walker, the sophomore who played a lot of minutes as a freshman, she was thrown into the fire, and that's going to be a travel on Boston.
Kentucky in every possession, when they get the ball, forget about running an offense. They are getting downhill and trying to get to the rim.
Now, that was something that Kyra Elzey started shoot around with today. Keys for Kentucky. She circled her team up and said, transition offense, push, push, push.
But the biggest thing Kyra pointed out was the mentality. She said, you cannot back down, to bring that toughness. And they all, in blue, they bought in. They said they're all about it.
That's a travel on Adi Aye. Kyra Elzey in her third season, and obviously the highlight of her head coaching at Kentucky has been that win in the SEC Tournament Championship game against the South Carolina team last year.
That was a phenomenal finals for what Kentucky did, fighting their way through that SEC Tournament, getting all the way to the finals and winning it. Wow.
Robin Benton going to the rack, and she's fouled. That's going to be on Victoria Saxton, her first.
Ask Kyra if she really referred to that championship game, to this year's team, and talking about refuse to lose mentality, because that's one of the things that she talks about, refuse to lose. And she said, I really don't bring up last year because I have so many new pieces. She's got 10 new players on this team. Six of them are freshmen. And so really to put the pressure of what those veterans did last year, probably not fair to put on this young group.
Yeah, Kentucky is the youngest team in the SEC. Two drop in for Robin Benton.
Now Kentucky in a three-quarter court press.
Cook working the baseline. Victoria Saxon took the rebound away from her teammate. Both of them crash in the glass. And that's a foul on Jada Walker.
You gotta love how hard Victoria Saxon works inside. She has really put on that coat and said, I'm the offensive rebound. She already has four today. That's only a little less than 5 minutes into the ballgame.
Well, she told us last year. It comes from her heart.
It comes from her heart. She sure did.
That's going to be an offensive foul. Second on Saxton.
Who was that foul on?
It was on Saxton.
Oh, posting up, displacing the defense.
Kennedy Cambridge, number 3 in blue, has checked in for Kentucky. You might know that name. Her sister Jordan plays at Vanderbilt, injured this season, but
she's got two brothers that play at Arizona State. And wait till you see Jelani.
Yeah, watch out for little sis.
Oh, the number one recruit in class 2024.
Sheer in trouble, over to Blair Green. The step back. Blair Green!
Look, the band tried to trick her, and really a little early on the shot clock, Blair Green said, no problem.
Blair Green, a leader for this Kentucky team, back after tearing her Achilles in a preseason scrimmage last season. Fletcher for two. Green for two, and Victoria Saxon got a hand on that shot. Three Beals short on the layup. Back the other way, Jada Walker.
Walker ain't gonna wait.
She pulls up and shoots over Boston. Back and forth we go, track meet. Saxton finishes.
I don't know if Kentucky wants to try to get into a foot race with South Carolina. You see Kyra Elzey telling her team to slow it down.
Fifth lead change early on here in the first quarter. Sheer waiting on the screen from Adeyeye. She'll let it fly from three, and it's short. Adeyeye with the offensive board.
We were talking before the game. I think that Kentucky's got to make threes to take down South Carolina, and I think the number of threes has got to be in double digits.
They've got two makes right now. 2 seconds. Adeyeye elevates, shoots right over Kira Fletcher.
That's what Kyra Elzey wants. Use all the shot clock. Limit the number of possessions that South Carolina has. And once it gets late, then knock down the shot.
As she mentioned, if we can't run and push in transition, then make them defend us. Victoria Saxon by herself.
But where did she get that pass from? Zaya Cook. And that's the area. It's not just about making shots for Zaya Cook, but the distribution, the other areas of her game she's taken such pride in.
Yeah, she's got two assists already. Look, her defense, too, is jacked up.
I'd love it. Yeah. I'd love how she's playing in her senior year.
Cambridge back to Adeyeye. Good ball movement.
Kentucky's got the lead here in Columbia, South Carolina.
Cook. Landed a little awkwardly, but she does get up, and you can count that. Put her at the free throw line. Tight game here. We mentioned it. This Kentucky team, the last team to beat South Carolina. We look back at that moment in the Music City when we come back. It was a moment that will live on forever in Kentucky women's basketball history, beating the number one team, not just in the SEC, but the number one team in the nation last year in Nashville. Dre Edwards, top of the key with the three! Big Blue Madness in March! Dre Edwards with the big three to seal the win for Kentucky. It was wild. We were at, obviously, we did that game. It was incredible to watch Kentucky's fight.
They did not back down, Kentucky. They came in with the mentality of they were going to go home champions. They competed start to finish. The Gamecocks had 0 points in the final 5 minutes of that game. The defense is where Kentucky held their hat.
Look, but you know the rest of the story. South Carolina regrouped and they went on to win a national championship.
They did, but Kentucky has to be so proud. That group, like you said, hadn't won an SEC championship in 40 years.
A very big moment, a big moment for Kyra Elzey and this Kentucky program. Now a lot of new faces on this Kentucky team that weren't a part of that, but still cool. And of course, you know, South Carolina hasn't forgotten that.
Oh no, you know that that's in the back of their mind. But how these two teams are going back and forth today, we're getting for a good one. It started out this way in Lexington, no less here in Columbia.
Zaya Cook is at the free throw line. She was fouled by Addie Adieye, completing the three-point play, and so Cook will check out. 5 points for Zaya Cook, and Breezy Hall, as they call her, coming into the game. Number 23 in white for South Carolina. Stolen away by Boston. Take it all the way, Aaliyah.
The versatility of her game. She's not just a back-to-the-basket post player. She's got a face-up game and handles.
Anaya Russell facing her old team. Started her career at South Carolina, part of last year's team. Raven Johnson, the pull-up. Look, when she comes in off the bench, that pace is going to pick up.
I was so excited about Raven Johnson coming in last season, then she tore ACL because I saw her in high school. I knew she was going to be something special. And now that she's back, recovered from that injury, when she comes in the game, the speed of the game, it goes up another notch.
Look, when you say you were excited, I think that's an understatement, because for the last 2 years, I have heard you be so excited about Raven Johnson. And Kentucky is going to call a timeout because it is a 9-0 run for South Carolina. They've hit their last six shots. Look, we saw, going back to that Aaliyah Boston play, the steal, the score. She's projected to be the top pick in the WNBA draft.
There's no question that she's going to be the number one pick in the draft. She has such a terrific presence on the floor. She also has a high basketball IQ. She knows where she is. She knows where to be and what she needs to do. You know, her scoring, we talked about the versatility in the paint. She's got a mid-range. She also has a three. She gets on the glass rebounding-wise. We talked about her court awareness. Look, I ran out of spots to put a category. She's also a shot blocker. There's not much Aaliyah Boston can't do. She is pro-ready.
Watching her at practice yesterday, she is constantly communicating. She knows exactly where everybody's supposed to be. Even if she's not in on the drill, she's directing from the sideline.
And she did that coming in as a freshman. We talked to her a little bit before the game. There's a special guest here tonight. Asia Wilson is here. You know, the woman who has a statue out in front of Colonial Life Arena.
Is that her?
Oh, that's her, right there.
Just kidding.
But how about having a mentor like Asia Wilson for Aaliyah Boston to prepare her for that next level?
Yeah, Asia's going to join us in the third quarter. The WNBA MVP, two-time MVP, and WNBA champion. One heck of a practice player today for South Carolina.
Asia Wilson never stops laughing or dancing. It's constant. She is such a fun young woman to be around.
Under a minute here in the first quarter, South Carolina is on a 9-0 run. And Robin Benton is fouled by Leticia Mihir. That'll be her first.
going back to how this year's team is different from last year's South Carolina team, the depth. Dawn Staley has so many different weapons, and when she goes to her bench, this team has the potential to even take it up another notch. It's not just holding what your starters or the lead the starters got going with, but they can come in and take it to another level.
Yeah, they're averaging almost 40 points per game coming off the bench. That's 48% of their points come from their players off the bench.
And 24 rebounds per game from the reserves. I would say the next line.
Thrown inside to Watkins. Too much traffic. Walker out with it, and Ashlyn Watkins got it right back. Time for South Carolina to take the last shot. Hall's going to pull up. Raven to Camila Cardoso. To the free throw line.
When you have 6-7 on the floor and the clock's running down, all you got to do is throw it up around the rim, and Camila Cardoso can go get it.
That's the second foul on Adeyeye. You know, going back to South Carolina's depth, sometimes we see it where maybe a coach is trying to play too many players and it causes some problems on the floor. It's not the case with South Carolina. They seem to figure out this rotation and they play a lot of people.
What I see from South Carolina is that each player knows their role and plays to their strengths. So when they come in, they don't try to play and be somebody else. So when they come onto the floor, Raven Johnson knows that she's to pick up the speed and push in transition. Ashlyn Watkins knows she's going to go rebound and get it done in the paint.
Anaya Russell with the heave. But South Carolina ending the quarter on an 11-2 run. When we come back, the Dawn Staley effect, the difference she has made leading this Gamecock program.
Connecticut seeking a 12th national title. South Carolina trying to become the eighth school to win multiple national championships. South Carolina couldn't have scripted the start any better. Fewest points in a first quarter this season for Connecticut. Followed up by Boston. Here comes Henderson.
Incredible effort, start to finish.
It is not unfinished business any longer. South Carolina has captured its second national championship.
Championship banners up in the rafters here in Colonial Life Arena. Look, 17 seasons before Dawn Staley arrived, they had no SEC titles or Final Four appearances or national championships, and look what she's been able to accomplish at South Carolina.
When you look at the accomplishments of the titles and the wins, but I'm looking around here in CLA and the excitement that she has built here in Columbia. They've won the attendance record in, what, the last 7-8 years?
Last 8 years. They led the nation in attendance.
And I can remember coming to South Carolina, even as a player. I know that's when we played under candlelight, but with some peach baskets. But hardly anybody was in the arena. Now this place is packed, and it is all the buzz here in Columbia, South Carolina.
Little season comparison. What they did last year, that national championship season, compared to this year, they're scoring more points. Their rebounding margin is bigger. They're allowing fewer points.
Right on track. I mean, you don't rest on your laurels when you win a national championship. You got to figure out how to be better. And that's what Dawn Staley has done.
Bree Hall over to Watkins. Great court awareness by all of South Carolina.
What makes South Carolina so good defensively, too, is the length is able to defend all over the floor.
Pick out to Amir here. She'll go back inside to Cardoso.
Cardoso's kick out passes got to be a little more careful. She threw one away a little earlier.
Raven's going to reset here. 10 seconds. Asking for the screen. They just throw it up, 6-7. Bucket.
Cardoso needs to buy Raven Johnson
dinner tonight. She's getting her the basketball.
Ball stolen away by Bree Hall. And Maddie Shearer shut it down. Still alive.
You see how Raven Johnson takes charge from the top. She wants to get the ball inside.
Watkins somehow got that back and put it through the bucket. Timeout, Kentucky.
South Carolina, they've gotten back to what South Carolina does. Get the rebound, outlet, push, run, and then score it. Finish it. Watkins, Gamecocks, off the run.
Hey, speaking to Steffi's point about the bench players keeping things going, since South Carolina's starters sat down, Gamecocks are on a 13-2 run.
We talked about when Dawn Staley, I wanted to say put in her reserves, just put in her next line, because probably anywhere else in the country, that group could be in the starting lineup. You just got five spots here. But they come in and really take the game up another level.
Yeah, they started the second quarter. None of the starters did. She went with all five bench players to start the second quarter.
Every team has got to be concerned, their opponents of South Carolina, of, okay, my starters, my next unit's got to be ready to go. Otherwise, South Carolina can just take over. South Carolina coming out of that timeout, bringing a little full court pressure.
They're on a 17-2 run. Kentucky looking for some offense. Jada Walker found it.
This sophomore right here has no fear. Jada Walker brings that gritty, that toughness.
Well, she had no choice. She was thrown in the fire last year. Robin Bitten with the steal. And the transition bucket.
Well, Kyra Elsey knows this game is going to be a game of runs. You've got to sustain South Carolina's runs and create some runs of your own. Now Kentucky looking to bring some pressure, trapping.
And she's still able to put it down. Camila Cardoso.
Courtney, what'd I tell you? If you just throw it up around the rim, when you're in trouble, Camila Cardoso, she's going to pull it down. She's going to be able to grab it and score it. And not only that, now she's going to the free throw line.
Now, she was the number five overall player, the number one center in her class, originally from Brazil, but moved to the U.S. at age 15. She played at Hamilton Heights in Chattanooga, Tennessee.
She did, and I went to go watch her play when she was in high school, and watching the development from high school to where she is now. The thing about it is when you watch Camila, even if she fouls, she's smiling.
She is.
So you look at her and you go, she's just too daggone nice.
I don't know. She can block a shot, though.
Yes, she can. When she gets fired up and playing with some emotion.
That one comes down to the hands of L.A., Leticia Amee here. Oh, Robin Benton almost had it back. Cambridge does. Up ahead to Shearer. On the trail, and that's a travel. Seven turnovers now for Kentucky.
We asked Dawn Staley what happened in Lexington, and she said, look, Kentucky was aggressive and they got downhill. They got at us. They came at us. And so that was a focus here today, was that it had to be the other way around. It had to be South Carolina that was the aggressor and looking to attack and then play a terrific defense.
Yes, Kentucky actually led the first meeting by 10 points, but then they gave up a 16-0 run to South Carolina.
Well, that's just because of, like we talked about, the depth. Fatigue can set in with the starters of Kentucky, where South Carolina can keep legs. Thank you. Rehal is such a terrific defender.
Blair Green, the two.
It's going to be one-on-one defense when Kentucky comes down. They're looking to make plays right away, not necessarily run plays.
Watkins short on the turnaround, and it's going to be Kentucky basketball.
You see, Camilla, she's smiling. She got called for the foul, but she was smiling.
Her first, Aaliyah Boston coming back in. Zaya Cook back in the game for South Carolina. Boston has 4 points, 2 rebounds. She's had a double-double in their last 6 games. Look, you mentioned the depth, too. Aaliyah Boston's still doing what Aaliyah Boston does, almost averaging a double-double. She's playing fewer minutes and still doing all of that.
Yeah, she's playing a little under 17 minutes a game and still putting up great numbers. I think voters have to keep that into consideration when they're going back and looking at Player of the Year. She's a big reason the players around her are able to have upped their game because so much attention is paid to her.
We mentioned Cardoso in the shot block. There it was.
She's going to get a few of those in every game.
Six seconds for Kentucky. And Shear is fouled by Cardoso. That'll be her second.
This is going to be an interesting matchup. Kentucky with 4 guards on the floor. South Carolina, Saxon, a traditional post. Aaliyah Boston, a traditional post. Leticia Mihir can play anywhere she wants to.
Yep.
I mean, 1 through 5.
Yeah, she ran the point some last year. Destiny Henderson was out for a couple of games, and
right.
L.A. ran the point. Too good for Maddie Shear. She's up to 5 points. Again, had the career-high 25 points in the first meeting with South Carolina. High post to Saxton, the kick out to Zaya Cook. There's a foul away from the shot. It's the third on Nia Leverutter.
Yeah, Kentucky has started to extend that zone. In the first quarter, the zone was pretty packed in the paint. Now they're trying to extend it, creep out a little bit. What is South Carolina doing? But they're sending a flasher to that midpoint, to the nail and the free throw line. Once the ball gets there, the South Carolina offense has options.
Boston had a couple looks. Kentucky's defense stepping up. Asia Petty in the game now. Robin Benton, the transition three. Yes. She's got 11.
Now, Kyra Elzey calls Robin Benton Showtime.
But
Robin wants it to be, her nickname to be Primetime. And Kyra Elzey said, before you can be Primetime, you got to bring it consistently. And so far she has over the last couple of games.
Especially on the road. Robin Benton, her average goes up on the road.
Absolutely, and running in transition before the defense can catch up. She eyes it, dies it, knocks it down.
Benton now has a 3-pointer in her last 16 games. Cook got tripped up going across the lane. We mentioned it. Her numbers are better on the road, which is really interesting.
Maybe they need to change the interior at Memorial Coliseum.
Does it count if they go play in Rupp? Different gen?
Well, I mean, I haven't checked the numbers of Rupp versus Memorial, but in the schools that were shown on the screen, I mean, she's 18-plus points a game.
Yeah, averaging 22.4 points per game on the road. Averages 17 a game overall in the season. 2 free throws for Zaya Cook.
Maybe Kyra Elzey needs to put her in a hotel room the night before home games.
Shear working hard against Kiara Fletcher, and she's going to the free throw line.
Can't you see the difference in Maddie Shear from the games we had earlier in the season? A lot of times she was putting the ball on the floor with the mindset of distributing. Now she's got the ball on the puts the ball on the floor. She's looking on ways to score. Then if the defense takes that away, she's a willing passer, but she has diversified her game.
Now started her career at Oregon, came back to her home state of Kentucky. A handful of players who were Kentucky high school stars now playing for the Kentucky Wildcats. But Kyra Elzey told us, look, we told her coming in, we need you to score. Maybe it was a lot of pressure. She was pressing a little bit. So later in the season, she said, Maddie, we don't need you to score anymore. I want you to focus on your defense, your rebounding, your toughness. And guess what? The offense came.
Well, because Maddie's a natural basketball player. You don't have to order up what you need specifically from her. Like, you don't have to order it up from Aaliyah Boston. When the Gamecocks need a bucket, Thor can bring it.
Instacart. Drop it in. Robin Benton.
I'm going primetime.
Ooh.
Yeah, I've done away with the showtime, Coach Elzey. Robin Benton's trying to bring it.
13 points back inside to Boston. Somebody lost a shoe and just threw it at the Kentucky bench.
Well, he's a petty. You see Robin Benton. She's bringing some toot, as in attitude, to the floor. She's got her offense working, and then defensively, she can bring it as well. Both sides of the ball, number one in blue, Robin Benton.
And Kentucky has hit five of its last seven shots. Shoe back on the foot of Asia Petty. We're ready to go.
Losing a shoe was made famous by Angel Reese. I don't care what anybody says. The block shot, holding the shoe.
Fletcher, perfect position to rebound. Nobody was around her. Eight second chance points for South Carolina. Green back to Petty. Aaliyah Boston on the board. 6 points, five rebounds for Aaliyah. And Fletcher throws it away. Held ball, possession arrow to South Carolina.
Now, I don't know what Kiara Fletcher saw trying to get the ball inside to me here. She had three players around her. That was a force. You look, there's three players, and she telegraphed it. Robin Benton played way off of her. She's got to recognize that.
Zaya Cook, too much.
And the defense now has collapsed back for Kentucky, protecting, more protective of the paint.
Fletcher with the steal. Letitia Mihir with the rebound. Fell right in her lap.
A missed shot for South Carolina is like an assist.
That'll stay with Carolina. 10 offensive rebounds for South Carolina. They average 18 and a half per game. Second in the nation in offensive rebounds.
And it's not just the post. The posts get their share, but guards rebound as well. And keep an eye on the SEC. In the middle, that's the soft part of the zone.
Letitia Mihir at the top of the key. Jada Walker going. Somebody else has lost a shoe again. It's like shoe carnival in here.
Asia Petty again.
First foul on Blair Green. It'll be Bree Beal at the free throw line. She's got 9 points, hit a couple of threes.
Look at Beal, getting on the boards. You know what I call that?
Bully ball.
You know it.
Yeah, Bree Beal came into South Carolina, part of that number one recruiting class. Got in the starting lineup right away because of her defense. And look, it's now in her senior season. Her main defensive assignment is only averaging 3.7 points per game.
And she gets the assignment of the best player more times than not on the opponent's team.
It's a 7-0 run for Carolina. Robin Benton's shot bounces out. Petty, put back. Asia Petty, the transfer from LSU, her first points. And it'll be Kentucky ball.
Those turnovers. Dawn Staley representing the Philadelphia Eagles.
The hoodie jersey, that's a baller move.
What about Dawn Staley? Isn't a baller move.
That's true. And me here.
Now this is the ball screen that South Carolina got hung on in Lexington, was a problem.
That was the first thing they worked on at practice yesterday too.
Look, as Amir took off, you see the bench jumping up and down in the background. They wanted her to dunk it.
She can. She's believed to be the first Canadian woman to dunk in a game, and she did it when she was 15.
That's incredible.
It's also the age I dunked for the first time.
That's incredible. But you look, South Carolina has Amir who can dunk, Saxton who can dunk, Ashlyn Watkins, who's done it in the game, was the first Gamecock player to have ever done it.
South Carolina takes a timeout here. Yeah, that was earlier this year against Clemson, and the bench got pretty lit after this happened.
I was sitting at home watching it, and as she took off, I watched her. She won the dunk. The high school Powerade dunk contest, but to do it in a college game in your freshman season, yeah, that's how I was jumping around in my living room when I saw that happen.
It was so cool. She was the number 12 recruit in this class, the South Carolina Gatorade Player of the Year. And in the record books, the first South Carolina Gamecock to dunk in a game.
Now, she also hit a three in that game. And so I asked her, I said, which were you more excited about, hitting the three or the dunk? And you know what she told me?
The three. She's one for one from three.
100%.
No doubt. So the shot clock's still on, 0.9 difference. South Carolina coming out of that timeout they just called.
Got to believe Dawn Staley talking to her team about time management. Execution right here.
Fletcher in trouble. It finds itself in the hands of Aaliyah Boston. Up and in on the second time, pad the stat sheet. And at the half, South Carolina up 50-35. 14th time this season they have led by 10 or more at the half. Alyssa, ladies, take it away. At the half, the number one team in the nation, up 50-35 on Kentucky. South Carolina, they have won 27 straight games, looking to make it 28. Back with you in Colonial Life Arena, Courtney Lyle and Carolyn Packen. It's become the tale as old as time. South Carolina getting paint points.
South Carolina has almost as many paint points as Kentucky has as a whole complete team. And they have gotten all over the glass. They've gotten second chance points. They have the length, the ability to throw over the top of Kentucky, and they've been able to finish. The guards have gotten involved. The posts have gotten involved. Kentucky's going to have to try to find a way to really buckle down in that zone and keep South Carolina outside, force outside shots.
34 points in the paint for South Carolina. Aaliyah Boston, by the way, 8 points, 8 rebounds, 4 of 9 from the field. She played 14 minutes in the first half, and she's seeking that 7th consecutive double-double.
That would be double-double number 75 in her career.
Ooh. Already holds the South Carolina record. Look, early on, though, Kentucky had some moments. They led a few times. It was back and forth a little bit. What was working well when that was happening for Kentucky?
For Kentucky, they had really collapsed. They started out the game collapsing inside and forcing everything from the perimeter, and South Carolina was turning the ball over and taking some ill-advised shots. Blair Green came out of the locker room locked and loaded.
Little bank shot for Green. Brings her up to 8 points.
And see, Kentucky's gone back to that 2-3 zone. The other factor is foul trouble. Nia Leverrutter had three fouls in that first half.
Yeah, Leverrutter, number 21 in blue for Kentucky. If they need all the help they can get down low, Jada Walker with the layup.
South Carolina's death played a part, too, in that first half. And they could go 9-10 deep.
And 9 different players scored for South Carolina in the first half. Bree Beal, short on that three. She's got 2 made threes tonight.
But at this point for Kentucky, that's a win. If they can force South Carolina to take shots from the perimeter, that's not what Kentucky can allow.
The miss underneath by Victoria Saxon, and South Carolina still hasn't scored in this quarter. Robin Benton at the SEC logo. And Zaya Cook lost it. It'll be Kentucky ball.
Can Maddie Shear get 25 points like she did the first time these two teams met?
This will stay with Kentucky. Shear has 7.
But the focus, the answer, the eraser, Aaliyah Boston inside.
Turnover, South Carolina ball. Kentucky's come out and scored 5 points out of the locker room. South Carolina hasn't responded yet.
When South Carolina's not scoring, you have got to make sure you can get touches for Aaliyah Boston.
She's got 2 players on her.
Nia Leverrutter's not leaving her side.
Fletcher's shot misses. Maddie Shear back to Robin Benton, who leads Kentucky. She's got 13 on the night already, talking about Benton. Blair Green, too much. Foul on the floor, and it's on Aaliyah Boston, her first.
Nia Leverrutter, you watch. Wherever Aaliyah Boston goes, there's going to be help. And Leverrutter stays connected like glue attached to Boston.
Jada Walker working around Fletcher. She does off the glass.
Walker is finding a way to find paint points herself, and she's the smallest player on the floor.
Kentucky has outscored South Carolina in the third quarter, 7-0. It's Aldaya Cook. Cook 1-for-7 now, but the putback is there. Aaliyah Boston puts her in double figures and gives her that double-double. 10 points, 10 rebounds, 11 rebounds, excuse me.
How did Aaliyah Boston get that bucket? Well, Everetter lost her. She did not maintain contact. Aaliyah Boston got away from her and got the putback.
Nia Leveretter was just called for her fourth foul, so she takes a seat. 75 double-doubles for Aaliyah Boston. She's chasing that record by Sylvia Fowles of 86. Jada Walker gonna push.
You look, Kentucky knows they've got to try to score any opportunity they have in transition because of the length of South Carolina.
Robin Benton getting inside and drawing the foul. That's the third on Victoria Saxton.
You can tell Kentucky has taken on the mentality of Kyra Elzey of saying, don't back down. Just because South Carolina has that length, Kentucky's still putting their head down and trying to create opportunities to get points at the rim or get to the free throw line.
That's the first free throw missed by Kentucky. They started 11-for-11 from the free throw line. Third foul on Adieye. So Kentucky, while outscoring South Carolina here in the third quarter, they've got some foul trouble with Leveretter on the bench with four fouls, and now Adieye goes to the bench with three.
Well, what I was looking at is in the first quarter, South Carolina outscored Kentucky 26-18. Second quarter, 24-7. What will be the differential coming out of the locker room in the third quarter?
South Carolina's moved over to Raven Johnson running the point. Bree Beal trying to throw to Cardoso. Cook steps in. Her shot's blocked. Here goes Benton. Blair Green transition three! Blair Green! 11 points now. She's 3-for-3 from behind the arc.
The three-point shot was the Achilles heel of South Carolina in that SEC tournament championship game.
Cardoso misses. Boston puts it back. Second chance points for Carolina. And Robin Benton is fouled by Bree Beal.
Benton looking to create her own. Got Blair Green that has established herself from the perimeter. Benton then going one-on-one against Bree Beal. Get some freebies.
Look, Kyra Elzey, we talked about it. Circled up her team at shoot-around today. One of the things she told them, you got to be tough. They've come out of the locker room really tough.
And she kept saying, refuse to lose. When you hear a coach continue to repeat the same thing, a mentality, it can become contagious.
Kentucky has outscored South Carolina 13-4 now in the third quarter.
Yeah, Kentucky knows they played with South Carolina for about three quarters in Lexington. It was that fourth quarter where South Carolina was able to create some separation.
Asia Petty with the foul. Second personal on Petty. Cardoso on the inbounds. And Robin Benton got herself back to the free throw line. It's going to be the second on Bree Beal. When we come back, We're going to have a two-time WNBA MVP joining us, Asia Wilson. We'll hop on the microphone when we come back to Columbia.
My grandmother, Hattie Rakes, grew up in this area, actually four blocks from the governor's mansion to be exact. When she was a child, she couldn't even walk on the grounds of the University of South Carolina. She would have to walk around the campus just to get to where she needed to go. If only she was here today to see that the same grounds she had to walk around, it now is the same grounds that houses a statue of her granddaughter.
That is a moment in Gamecock history that we will never forget. The statue outside of Colonial Life Arena of the great Asia Wilson, the South Carolina native who stayed at home, got South Carolina a national championship, and guess what? She is joining us now, a two-time WNBA MVP and a WNBA champion. Asia, thank you so much for joining us. What's it like to be back when you come back and see the team and see Dawn?
Oh, man. I mean, first, thank you for having me. I love this. But it's been truly special to finally come back home and to just take it all in. It's like I missed it. I missed it a lot. And have an opportunity to see Coach Daly and, of course, talk with the girls today. It just brings it all back. It brings all the feels back. And I'm like, when they showed that picture of my grandmother, I was like, oh my goodness, here comes the waterworks. But this is home through and through. Like, I love this place. This place has watched me grow up as a player and the person that I am today. So when I can come back and show love and support, it's truly special.
You got to visit with the team today and really share with them. Dawn asked a lot of the questions to have you talk to them. Share with us some of the things you shared with the team.
Yeah, I mean, the biggest thing, I think, and something that Coach Daly kind of instills in us is just how to be a professional, not even just a professional athlete, but a pro as a whole, and that's what it takes. So just giving them little nuggets to take, to keep with them, to know that the next level at the W, it's a business, it's a job, but it's a good one. It's an elite group of women, I tell you that.
You see one who could be playing at the W next year, Leah Boston with the steal and then taking it up the floor. Should we talk to her pregame? She said, you guys text and communicate some?
Yes.
Do you tell her?
I mean, I've been in her situation. It's kind of like identical in a sense. And so I just wanted to make sure that she knew that I was here for her no matter what. Like, it's no – I love it. I love when she's shattering records. I love that she's taking over this program the way that she is. And she's handling it with a lot more grace than I say that I would. She wears it with a smile. And I just kind of just – continue to be in her ear. Be that person that I wish I had.
How would you feel about if they put another little statue outside?
That would be super dope. I think it's something that's truly special, and I think we have enough space out there. But, I mean, she's putting on for her hometown as well, and I know they're proud of her. So, I mean, I wouldn't mind having some company. It's always good out there. It's always good to put on for women's sports, especially we're a women's basketball school. I can say that now.
Yeah. Oh, heck yeah. When you watch the South Carolina team, what stands out about this group?
They're just big. I mean, I know people said that about us, but no, this is a big team across the board, and I don't think they understand how big they are. And I think that's the beautiful thing about it. It's still, oh, God.
Did you mean like that?
Speaking
of
big.
Right on cue. Oh, my goodness. Yes, this means a lot. This is exactly what I was talking about. Just big teams using their size. And I think when they utilize it, you see it right there with an easy block with Cat. Like, just clean. And she just moved her ponytail out the way. And she's like, okay, back to work. So I don't think they realize how big they are. And that's what makes them special is utilizing their size and, like, just taking care of the paint, protecting that paint is special.
Yeah, there's again Camila Cardoso again with another block.
Yes.
Well, and the versatility of South Carolina. They have, you know, Dawn Staley wants to get points in the paint, but now guards are scoring confidently as well.
Yes, I mean, you just had about 3-4 blocks in that possession, and that, you got to protect the house, and that's what they do. And then on the offensive end, you know, they just overpower and oversize people.
You know, we were talking, too, about how important the depth has been. They rotate in 5 new players and nothing changes.
Yes. I mean,
that's going to be an offensive foul on Aaliyah, her second.
Oh, goodness.
Yeah, got called. Aaliyah took that left hand, pushed off a little bit once she gained possession, but she was just trying to protect the basketball. It's just that extension of the arm. The officials are going to call that.
Yeah. Nothing like a little Kentucky-South Carolina rivalry. I always love this game.
Oh, absolutely.
I love it.
Okay, but free agency going on. You all just
really?
Got.
Free agency's going
yeah,
on?
Yeah, it's going on.
I did not know that. Yeah. What? No wonder I gained a couple new teammates.
There you
okay,
go.
It makes sense now.
A couple of big ones. You got Candace Parker is coming to Las Vegas.
Yeah, that was a huge thing for us. I mean, that is right. I totally missed that.
Oh, did you? Right?
I totally missed that. I was wondering why Candace was texting my phone. I was like, okay, girl, hey. No, but I'm super excited. I think we have a team that's solid through and through. From 1 through 12, however we are, I think we're ready to work and coming in. And we know that target on our back just got a little bit bigger, so I'm excited for it.
You mentioned work today, and I loved what you told this team about how hard you have to work on the next level.
Yeah, I think people kind of see the resume or see what we do on the court and think that and we make it look easy. But the work that we have to put in on the offseason and everyone else in between, it's crazy. It takes a lot of work.
Well, and you set the great example. And that's why, two-time WNBA MVP.
Asia, thank you so much. We appreciate your time. Enjoy the rest of the game.
Thank you guys.
You know, we mentioned Asia talking to the team, and after she spoke to them about the hard work that it takes to play in the WNBA and just the change from college to the pros, Raven Johnson raised her hand and asked a really cool question.
Yeah, she asked her about the relationship between Chelsea Gray and Asia. And Asia said, the big and the point guard have to have a great relationship. And it's on the floor and off the floor. And if you have a great relationship between your point guard and your big, the other three fall into line. And that was the case with the Las Vegas Aces. Those two have a great connection. Chelsea Gray is a fantastic, one of the best point guards in the world. And then to have a great player, MVP like Asia Wilson, then you can have Nakia Stokes, Kelsey Plum, to be able to come in, Jackie Young, to fill in all the other spots to be world champions.
It's a 6-0 run right now for South Carolina. Kentucky hasn't scored in over 2.5 minutes. You know, Asia Wilson, of course, was the number one pick in the WNBA draft when she was coming out of South Carolina, and now Aaliyah Boston is projected to be the top pick in this year's WNBA draft.
And imagine if Indiana, as they fall true to form and take Aaliyah Boston. Who did Indiana pick up last season?
Henny
and Boston reconnect. Hey,
spicy.
Everybody in Indiana, you better get your tickets.
Yeah.
Because Lynn Dunn is putting together a crew. They're young. You know, they've got Queen Igbo. They have Nelissa Smith, who had a terrific rookie season. And those young players got a lot of great experience last year. Indiana has a new coach in Christy Sides.
Maddie Shear driving in, trying to end this 3-minute scoring drought for Kentucky. Walker in trouble. Blocked by Raven Johnson.
I love the spunk of this redshirt freshman. And I love that she was the one that asked the question. Like, she was just trying to figure out, you know, how can I get to your level? What does it take?
Adeyeye, her shot affected by Camila Cardoso. Raven Sarr got it to her, Cardoso. Two more.
And she's smiling.
Obviously, 12 points, 2 rebounds for Camila Cardoso. 9-0 run now for Carolina.
South Carolina off and running, and they do it so well. The brick can be led by Raven Johnson, Bree Beal. The post can bring it as well, and Cardoso running right down Main Street. This draft's going to be interesting. And just looking at this roster here in South Carolina, you have Aaliyah Boston, Zaya Cook's stock in the draft is going up. Bree Beal, that's going to be a steal.
And I didn't mean to rhyme, but it
can happen.
I can't stand you.
But Bree Bill and what she brings, we talked about the defense that she has. Now she's demonstrating she can shoot the three and she can defend multiple positions on the floor.
Now shooting 40% from three this year, has 22 made threes. She'll check out. Bree Hall in. Almost a four-minute scoring drought now for Kentucky, and they're in some foul trouble. Adeyeye just picked up her fourth. Nia Leverrutter has her fourth foul. That's two players inside Kentucky needs.
Well, that's the biggest difference. When the scoring drought for Kentucky and the run of South Carolina is Leverrutter being in foul trouble.
Yeah.
Because she was the one that was really wreaking havoc and making it difficult for South Carolina to get the ball inside. And then what does Dawn Staley do? Go to 6-7. And you've got Camilla Cardoso on the floor. And Raven Johnson just picked up the pace of this ball game.
Cardoso called for her third foul. Here's Maddie Shear. Shear with 8 points now. Make it 9. Ashlyn Watkins checking in to replace Cardoso.
I was just here thinking, when will Kentucky bring that full court pressure and try to start forcing South Carolina to turn the ball over instead of just letting them come down and run their offense? But bring that, what Kentucky was known for, their 40 minutes of dread.
Yeah, they were pressing the whole time.
Exactly. They've got the depth. They've got young players. Why not try to force South Carolina to do something different?
Well, the double team forces the turnover by Leticia Ami here. A minute to go here in the third. Jada Walker. Cook. Layup. Just her second made field goal. She's 2 for 9 today. 9 points for Zaya Cook, who averages 15. Offensive foul.
South Carolina is so well connected. In transition, everybody does a little of something to help each other out. You got Watkins, the kick out. You have Raven Johnson looking down the floor. And you see Leticia Ami here? Was she getting position or setting a screen? Whatever worked, she got the open lane for Zaya Cook.
Second foul whistled against Maddie Shear in South Carolina with its largest lead. Ten seconds for the Gamecocks. Watkins going up. Time winding down in the quarter. Maddie Shear on the move. Blocked by Watkins.
Ashlyn Watkins. Look, she didn't show any emotion on her face, but she gets the job done. That is such an athletic freshman for the Gamecocks.
A 6-minute scoring drought for Kentucky, and South Carolina up 67 to 50. One more quarter to play here in Columbia.
South Carolina up 17, and what do we have? Oh, a little peck, yeah! And it has to do on the defensive end. The Gamecocks have 12 blocks already in this ballgame. Five different players have gotten in on the block action. The length, the timing, the tenacity of the Gamecocks, they brought it in the block department.
They average just over 9 blocks a game, already have 12. We still have 10 minutes to go. Well, Kentucky's in some foul trouble too right now.
That's true. Got Leverrutter on the bench. Adeyeye's on the bench.
Yeah, Leverrutter's got 4. Adeyeye has 4. And that's some of their size inside.
Yeah, really, Asia Petty's the only true post. Blair Green played some post a couple of years ago at the four, but still not the size to match South Carolina.
Petty with the stop.
Petty said, you need to talk about my defense.
Held ball possession arrow to Kentucky. You know, Kentucky really made a push in that third quarter coming out of the locker room. It took South Carolina a little while to find their offense. South Carolina did outscore Kentucky in the quarter, but only by 2 points.
Well, what Kentucky did in the third was attack the paint. Really challenge South Carolina one-on-one. I love watching Bree Hall play defense. She's got terrific length. You watch her eyes. And that's one of the things Don Staley constantly compliments Breezy Hall on, is her ability to play defense. You see her get down in a stance. And look, she doesn't run to the player, tries to beat her to the spot. She knows she's got the length to block the shot.
Yeah, this has been a big season for Bree Hall in her second year with South Carolina. Going up and finishing the layup. You know, Dawn, we asked Dawn about Breezy, and she said, look, she was tired of sitting. She chose to work hard, and it's paying off. That defense is now accompanied with better offense.
And I love it when coaches talk about players that if they're not getting the amount of minutes they want to play, instead of heading for the transfer portal, they went to work.
Yeah.
So that they can earn their spot.
You know, we asked Bree Hall, who got you into basketball? And she said, well, both my parents, neither played, but my dad really started me going 5 years old. They'd go to the gym, work on the right-hand layup, work on the left-handed layup. That one took a little longer.
She said, oh, I'm supposed to use this hand, pointing to her left hand? I feel her on that. It took me a while. She goes, it wasn't until the seventh grade when I got to use my left hand. And I'm thinking, I didn't really have to use mine until high school.
Yeah.
And it still wasn't very good.
What'd she tell us, though, about her sister, right? She's a better shooter?
Oh, yeah. And she's only 14. She hated to admit it, but she said, yeah, her sister's got a better shot.
So Naya Fagan coming into the game for South Carolina. First time that we have seen her. Look, she and Ashlyn Watkins kind of been battling. Sanaya missed some time with an injury, but Dawn's kind of waiting for one of them to really take hold of that position.
Well, because there's not but so many minutes in a game, and you know Aaliyah Boston's going to get hers. Victoria Saxon's going to get hers. Camilla Cardoso. So then, where's that fourth post? And to compete for that position, and you're right, Dawn said, which one of you is going to just take it and go, those are my minutes, and you got to earn them.
Watkins, a kick out to Letitia Mihir. Fresh 20, didn't eat all of it.
Okay, next time down, though, I want you to watch Ashlyn Watkins. She didn't come up with the rebound, but watch her vertical and how she's so quick to get off the floor.
At EAA. South Carolina ball. You know, talking specifically about Ashlyn Watkins, Coach Staley told us, look, she's really fundamental. She's extremely skilled. We're just trying to get her to be more aggressive.
And I think it's hard to be aggressive coming in because when you've got so much talent around you, you're like, okay, I don't want to do too much. I'm trying to stay in my lane. But I think that Dawn wants her to carve her own lane. Okay, Sanaya Fagan, there you go.
Swish. Adiyeye with some patience.
Jada Walker
I'm going to tell you, they won't go away. There's no quit in this Kentucky basketball team. You cannot relax. You see Kentucky going back to a man-to-man defense. The other effect that the depth of South Carolina, you can tell, I believe Kentucky looks a little fatigued. They've been worn down because of the fresh bodies that Dawn Staley's been able to put on the floor.
And that combined with some foul trouble, so that limits the bodies you have available for Kentucky coming off the bench.
Right, right.
First foul on Raven Johnson.
And Raven Johnson got that foul, but I also think that she's been a different player since she's come out of that knee brace. Beginning of the season, she was wearing a knee brace as she had recovered from the ACL. She's moving much freer, too, without wearing it.
Yeah, I noticed that because when we had them early on, she was messing with it. It was coming undone. And
it can be a little heavy, too.
It's like an offensive lineman brace.
Yeah, it was big.
Every player that's played for South Carolina tonight has scored.
You know it's about time. Olivia Thompson time.
Chloe Kitt's coming in right now. She's over at the scorer's table. Mid-year enrollee for South Carolina.
Yeah, she should be a senior in high school right now. Forewent her senior season to enroll at South Carolina for this second semester.
Bree Hall calling for it. She was alone. Robin Benton read the pass. South Carolina ball. Kitts is going to replace Raven Johnson.
That'll move Letitia Mehir to the point. I think she has played just about every position tonight, Mehir.
Oh, and Ashley Watkins going up to Maddie Shear. After she went up, and I think she tried to dunk this.
Ooh, you got a technical.
Yeah.
I think Watkins is a little upset. But Maddie Shear did what she was supposed to do as far as you try to not allow the score on a breakaway. If you're going to foul, you either get out of there or you try to not make it a three-point play.
So I think they called the foul on Shear on the bucket, and then they teed up Ashlyn Watkins. So they're going back to look at this at the monitor right now.
I think Maddie Shear made the right move there. Watkins is upset about it, but she can't go at Shear.
Mm-hmm.
they're looking at this play. They've called a foul on Maddie Shear, and then we saw them tee up Ashlyn Watkins.
What are they looking to see? Was there contact made from Watkins to Shear?
All right, we're going to get some more information. We'll step aside for now, but an official review happening here in Columbia.
So there was a foul that was called on Maddie Shear, and so that means that Ashlyn Watkins will shoot two shots. There was also a technical foul that was assessed to Ashlyn Walker, and so
Ashlyn Watkins.
So Kentucky will then shoot two shots, and then they will take the ball out at half court.
And anybody can shoot those two shots for Kentucky. That technical foul also counting as a personal foul against Ashlyn Watkins.
And they went to the monitor to see if there was anything extra that happened. And they didn't find anything.
So now anybody for Kentucky can take these two. So Maddie Shear will take them. These are for the technical foul. She's their leading free throw shooter at 92%. And it'll be Kentucky ball. Robin Benton on the fadeaway. Chloe Kitts with the rebound. And that's going to be an offensive foul on Kitts.
Well, that's what Jada Walker is not going to quit, not going to go down without a fight. And so it is her job at the top of the Kentucky defense to put pressure on the ball. And Kitts, she extends that arm, gets called for the offensive foul. Yeah, Benton's going to have to take over now. She's got to try to create and then have two shooters. She got Green. You also have Shear as options.
Fagan going coast to coast. Up ahead to Kitts. Chloe Kitts with the lay-in. Benton looking to create again, and she's going to be fouled by Fagan.
That's what Kentucky has been pretty successful with, of going one-on-one. And check out this crossover by Robin Benton to get to the basket and get to the free throw line.
Talesia Cooper has come in the game for the first time for South Carolina, replacing Leticia Mihir. First time we've seen Cooper since January 15th against Missouri. She was injured and then did not play in their last game against Alabama.
Well, and Cooper is, I think, a future point guard as well. She's got length. She's got terrific handles. Need to look her up. Look in the McDonald's All-Star game. She had a mean crossover, then cross back. She was breaking ankles.
It's a turnover there. And then Cooper's going to be called for the foul.
This young group for South Carolina has got to get it together, be able to handle the pressure of Kentucky. We brag so much on the depth.
Right.
Of South Carolina. Now this group's got to prove themselves as well.
Four. South Carolina averages 40 points from their bench. Tonight, 42.
Wow.
Yeah.
It was very impressive. When you look over there on the sideline, it's almost like looking at a WNBA team with the talent that Dawn Staley has.
So South Carolina calls a timeout. Look, this was an important game to not overlook because on the horizon for South Carolina is UConn coming up on Sunday, and that is at UConn.
And you look at the preparation that you've got to put into. Not only do you have to go to UConn, you come home, play LSU, and then you've got to go to Knoxville, and you've got to play at Thompson Bowling Arena.
Yeah, look at this UConn game coming up. Two programs that, one that's got a lot of history, one that's building a lot of history.
When you look at what they have done against ranked teams in the top 25 in the last five seasons, South Carolina 43 wins and UConn has 25. I mean, I'm looking forward to the game on Sunday and watching that. It's pretty impressive in what Connecticut's been able to do with the injuries that they have had. Their starters are playing, I think, 35 minutes a game. They're still beating teams by 34. They're out-rebounding them by 17.
Jada Walker from the baseline. Look, and then, you know, the next week you get LSU, who's also undefeated. LSU and South Carolina, the two undefeated teams left.
I'm looking forward to seeing Angel Reese go up against the length of South Carolina and specifically what she'll have to face going against Aaliyah Boston and Victoria Saxton. South Carolina's going to have to find an answer for breaking this Kentucky press. They've continued to turn the ball over. Dawn Staley's letting them, this young group, learn some lessons.
First on Anaya Russell.
Kentucky's still bringing the pressure.
Cooper almost lost it. Walker all over her. And that pressure really affecting South Carolina right now.
Well, and Cooper trying to break the press with a dribble facing two players. She's got to learn, trust your teammates. You can beat that with a pass.
Breezy.
I like her game. She can defend. I love her length, but she also has a three-point shot in her arsenal as well.
Scored the bucket, then got all the way back to stop Anaya Russell from having a layup. Walker the triple, no. Cooper sees Fagan alone.
The timeout that Dawn Staley took was to help this young group regroup and come together and understand what the assignment was.
So Kyra Elzey is going to call a full timeout here under 3 minutes to go in the game.
Well, she's got to get her group. Look, the press. South Carolina has been able to adjust a little bit. Now this young group of Gamecocks has been able to settle down. So I would suspect Kyra Elzey is going to look to change up her defense pressure, and she's got to go quick hit offense. You've got to score quick. You've got to get it. You've got to go. And it has to be quick attack to the basket and then kick out to the perimeter and try to find your shooters.
Meanwhile, the South Carolina team, remember, they have won 27 straight games. Their last loss was to Kentucky in the SEC tournament, but that's the longest active streak in the nation, looking for 28 in a row right now. They're outscoring opponents by 33 during this 27-game win streak.
And they've done so... How?
It has been getting points in the paint and dominating on the glass. And I'm looking for when they play Connecticut, and one of the things, Connecticut can score at all five spots. And you have Lou Lopez Seneschal, who really lit up Tennessee,
yeah,
shooting from the perimeter. Dorka Juhas is playing very well. That's a post player that can play inside and out. So they're going to look to possibly score on the perimeter against the size of South Carolina. And it's going to be fun to watch because UConn, those five, since they've been playing together at UConn, they're out-rebounding opponents by 17. They're going to be, it's a whole different challenge when you're trying to out-rebound South Carolina. Now everybody for South Carolina has been in the game. Olivia Thompson's in. She's a three-point specialist.
And Kitts throws it away into the hands of Anaya Russell.
And Kyra Helsey's got her team trying to execute through their offense. They need to look to score quick.
Step back from Russell. Olivia Thompson. Too much on the three.
Kitts knew where to, who to get the ball to, though. That's your three-point shooter on the perimeter.
Taking it in, Asia Petty took it away. We talked a little about the UConn matchup. When this South Carolina team plays LSU, what are you most excited to see when those two battle here in Colonial Life?
Well, I'm looking forward to the matchup of Angel Reese going inside, depending on who her matchup is, but also Alexis Morris, the point guard who is able to score and push tempo. This could be a fast-paced game. We saw tonight South Carolina looking to get up and down the floor in transition. LSU can have a transition game of their own. And I think that this is going to be the real true measurement test for LSU. We thought Tennessee was. Well, when you're going against the number one team in the country, you're looking at trying to move up to that number one seed in the bracket. You got to come to play when you come to Columbia.
At South Carolina, the depth, LSU doesn't have that depth.
They've got a little bit of depth.
But not like,
you know, they've got Kateri Poole that comes in off the bench. You also have Samaya Smith, who is a freshman. But not like the depth that South Carolina has.
You see both the identical records. The points per game differential, very similar. Obviously, LSU played an easier non-conference schedule. But again, Kim Mulkey didn't know the players she was going to have when she made that schedule last year.
Yeah, she was losing 80% of her offense when they completed that schedule. And then it was like Christmas. Those four transfers came in and have made a major impact. Everybody wants, to shoot the ball.
Foul's going to be called before Jenkins got it.
But from what I saw today, I like the confidence that South Carolina is playing with. And the potential to repeat, I think they've got all the tools to possibly do that. And Don Saley said, well, the stars line up. You got Philadelphia in the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Astros.
The Astros. She said,
like, now, 2017.
Yeah. But she said, now Philadelphia's got to do their part. No pressure on Super Bowl Sunday.
Gamecocks not overlooking this game and looking ahead to UConn, but now they can look at the Huskies. South Carolina showing off all its depth tonight, and a big win for the second time. They defeat Kentucky this season, 87-69.
It was an impressive show for the first string, the next string, and then the next. The depth of South Carolina is so much that any opponent has to deal with.
62 points in the paint for South Carolina. They get the victory tonight. 28 straight wins for the defending national champions.